Hello everyone and welcome to this course on creating successful lead magnets and sales funnel to grow your adventure travel business. I am your course instructor, Fernando Diaz, and I just want to start by congratulating you for making this amazing investment. I honestly believe you've made an amazing investment not only in yourself, but also in your business by acquiring this course. Because if you apply the materials that we're laying out for you, you'll have a methodology to capture contact details for visitors on your website, and you'll be able to turn those visitors into customers through a sales funnel. But before we begin, I just want to make sure that you do this course from beginning to end in the order that we've laid out. You may feel like perhaps you know some of the material in certain lessons better than others, and you may be inclined to jump around. I strongly discourage you from doing that because we'll be talking about theory and laying foundations in every lesson that will be applied for the subsequent lesson. So, as tempting as it can be to jump to lessons that perhaps may seem more interesting to you, just encourage you to do the lessons in that order from 1 to 7 and not skip around. The main problem with many adventure travel businesses today is that 1, they're not taking advantage of the people who are visiting their websites. 2, they're not consistently growing their email database. 3, they are not properly marketing to that database. But that's the problem that we're going to help you solve with this course. Just think about in your own business, how often do you email your clients? And what do you email them? Are you emailing them about? Are you like most companies, you know, who email your customers only when you have a special or an offer or a discount, when you're trying to get rid of excess inventory, or when you want to wish them, you know, a Merry Christmas, a Happy 4th of July, or a Happy New Year? Well, if you're like most businesses, you know, who email customers very sporadically and they don't hear from you again throughout the rest of the year, don't worry if you feel identified. Again, that's a problem that we're going to help you solve in this course on creating successful lead magnets and sales funnels to grow your adventure travel business. Let's begin. So who am I and what puts me in a position to teach this sort of material to you? Well, my name is Fernando Diaz, and in addition to being an adventure educator for the ATTA, I am also an ambassador for the country of Chile for the ATTA. But when I'm not doing stuff for the ATTA, I have a full-time job as director of marketing for Quasar Expeditions, a high-end adventure travel company with cruises in the Galapagos Islands and an overland safari operation in Patagonia. But the credentials that really matter for you, or, you know, the reasons why you should believe what I'm teaching in this course, is essentially 2. The first credential is the fact that I've been doing sales and marketing for the adventure travel industry for the last 16 years. So what does this mean to you guys watching this course? Well, this means that what I'm teaching you has 16 years of experience to back it up. So in this time, I've made plenty of mistakes and I've also made plenty of right calls. I've wasted a lot of marketing dollars, and I've also gotten amazing return on certain marketing expenses. So you're bypassing this learning curve, and I'm teaching you the stuff that works. Okay, and the second credential is the fact that I'm a StoryBrand certified marketing guide. If you're not familiar with StoryBrand, it's a concept that was developed by New York Times bestselling author Donald Miller, where he's actually using story to engage with an audience. And we're gonna use story on our sales funnel to keep in touch with people and to push them down the funnel from being, you know, people just searching or looking for a product and services to be in this buy now mode and to actually do business with us. So StoryBrand, it helps because it essentially it's allow us to build trust with an audience. So as with any relationship that requires trust for a commitment, we're going to build trust with our email contacts so, you know, that they will buy our product and service. We're going to speak to them in a way that makes them listen, and this will allow you to present your product as a solution to your customer's problem. The main objective of this course is to teach you how to create a lead magnet to capture contact details and then teach you how to market to those contact details via email using a sales funnel. It's a relatively simple process that can be broken up essentially in four parts. The first is, you know, we create a lead magnet. The second part is we capture contact details. The third part is we market to our audience through a nurture email sequence. And the fourth part is we're actually going to close the deal with a sales email sequence. That wraps up the full funnel and summarizes in very basic terms what we're going to be teaching you. And when you apply this properly, you will see greater sales for your business. But before we dive into the details of this course and the lessons, I just want to talk about the importance of sales and marketing for your business. And to do that, I want to bring an analogy, the analogy of a business compared to an airplane. So if your business is this airplane, sales and marketing are the left and the right engines. The overhead, that's the main fuselage or the body, and it has to be as light as possible for the plane to fly properly. Leadership is the cockpit, and the products are the wings. These are what gives, you know, essentially the company lift. And then finally, of course, we have the fuel. Now, the only thing more important than sales and marketing, which obviously, you know, provides the thrust for this business or this airplane to take off, is the fuel. And the fuel represents your company's cash flow. But assuming, you know, that cash flow is taken care of, and I'm teaching this course during COVID time, so it's probably not the best time to talk about cash flow, but let's assume that part is taken care of. The next thing you have to worry about is the sales and the marketing of your business. This is what you have to focus on for your company to grow, to thrive, and to survive. Because when you focus on sales and marketing, you will no longer be worried about where the next lead or the next sale is coming from. And we just have to admit that many of us who started our own business, we became marketers the day, you know, that we did that. We may not have studied marketing, but the day we decided to open a travel business or an adventure travel business of any sort, we were responsible for the marketing to generate the leads and the sales that our business needs to grow and to thrive. So whether you like it or not, you are a marketer and you have to focus on the sales and the marketing of your business for your organization to grow. That is essentially our responsibility. In case you haven't checked out my other course on how to design high converting websites to grow your business, I strongly recommend you do, because when you combine that course with this course, not only will you be able to create an amazing lead magnet and a great sales funnel, but you'll also be able to design an amazing website that will clearly spell out to customers what it is that you offer. With that clarity, they will know exactly what you buy, they will be engaged, and, you know, they will actually go into your sales funnel with much more ease. So I strongly recommend you check out that course. So who is this course on sales funnels for? Well, this course is for startups. This course is for well-established, you know, adventure travel businesses. It applies to all types of companies in the adventure travel space, you know, from tour operators to product owners to insurance companies, online gear stores, you name it. If you're in the adventure travel space and you have visitors on your website, this course applies to you. And it applies to businesses of any size, small and large. So basically, if you have a website and if you use that website to showcase and sell your product or service, this course is for you. If you have an email database that you currently do not do much with and you just have a bunch of contacts lying around, this course is for you. We're going to teach you what to do with those contacts. And if you want a better way of engaging with your customers and with prospects, this course is also for you. Now, this course is not a magic recipe, you know, to get leads from your website. This course is not for you if you're thinking, for example, that it's a done-for-you plug-and-play kind of deal. You have to understand how sales funnel works, and you have to have a deep understanding of your business to design a proper sales funnel for your audience. So if you think, you know, that what you learn here has a bunch of worksheets and models that you can just plug and play, I'm sorry, but this course is not for you. And if you do not have the intent on to invest in getting traffic to your website, I'm sorry to say that this course is also not for you. Because like with any businesses online, when there is no traffic going into a website, you can have a beautiful website, you can have a great lead magnet, you can have a great sales funnel, but if there are no eyeballs, you know, to check that out, it doesn't work. So investing in traffic is a requirement to make this work. And we talk about traffic in the final lesson. So here's a quick and basic outline of this course. It is composed of 7 lessons. In lesson 1, we're going to talk about value-based marketing. You're going to understand what value-based marketing is, and once you have a firm grasp on the concept, you will know how sales funnels are very, very important in this whole process. Lesson 2 is all about the lead magnet. It's the bait that we're going to use to capture contact details and put them into a sales funnel. Lesson 3 is talking about the power of email and why I consider email to be one of the most powerful marketing tools out there. Lesson 4 is about the nurture email sequence. These are emails that are meant to nurture a relationship with your customers, and there are many of these, and you will have to write many nurture email sequences, you know, in a given year, and we'll explain exactly, you know, how that works. Lesson 5 is about the sales email sequence. So while the nurture email sequence is meant to nurture a relationship with the client, the sales email sequence is meant to close the deal with emails that are focused on selling. Lesson 6 is about traffic. And as I said before, traffic is extremely important to make all this work. If you don't have traffic going to your website, there are no visitors to capture contact details from, and none of this sadly works. And finally, in lesson 7, we'll present a plan for execution, and we will provide a basic course conclusion that will get you in motion and set into action to make an amazing sales funnel for your company. All right, that is a basic outline of this course. And the final thing that I want to make note of is throughout the course, I present various worksheets and exercises that I want you not to skip. Please do these in full detail. They're meant for you to apply the material that you've learned, and you have to do them for every lesson, because at the end, we will need the material in these worksheets and in these exercises for the 3 final meetings that you need to have with your team to execute everything. That is this basic course outline, and I look forward to seeing you in lesson 1.